Good day to all our present. So this video is done by the Tagore Dental College and Hospital, Department of Public Health Dentistry. This is an educational video on Oral Hygiene Index Simplified. This is one of the most important index for any undergraduate to record during their exams. So here in this video, you will be taken into the details of how to score it, and then a demonstration of the same on a typhoid for a better understanding. So let us move on to this video. Students, today we are going to look into Simplified Oral Hygiene Index demonstration. This video is done by the Department of Public Health Dentistry for educational purpose. So before we move on to this index, let us be very familiar about certain terminologies which we will be using more frequently while recording this index. The first one is debris. Debris is nothing but a particulate matter which is composed of food particles which are loosely attached to your tooth surface. So these can be easily cleaned just by brushing your teeth properly or self-cleansing using your tongue and saliva. And next are the stains. These are products of chromogenic bacteria which can be either extrinsic or intrinsic depending upon the causal path, causative agent. These can be either due to the tobacco residues or food components, food beverages like tea and coffee, which will produce predominantly extrinsic stains, which will be recorded by this index. The next is the calculus. Calculus is nothing but a tenacious hard substance, which is formed by the calcification of dental plaque, composed primarily of calcium phosphate minerals, which is attached to your tooth surface and also contains certain viable microorganisms in it. So this index was proposed by John C. Green and Jack R. Vermillion in the year 1964. In this, we will be recording only certain teeth like 16, 11, 26, 36, 31 and 46, which we call them as index teeth. And in these index teeth, in the upper arch, all the labial or the buccal surfaces will only be recorded. In the lower arch, the posteriors, namely the 4-6 and 3-6, the lingual side will be recorded, and 3-1 labial side will be recorded. So if these index teeth are not present, then you will go for something called a substitution teeth, or the teeth which is present next to them. So in case of 1-6, you will go for 1-7 if it is absent. Even if 1-7 is missing, you will go for 1-8 if it is functional in nature. Similarly, it same goes for 2-6. But if 1-1 is missing, we will substitute them with 2-1. If 2-1 is missing, we do not have any substitution teeth. So the same thing applies for the lower arch. Posteriors, if 6 is missing, we will go for 7. 7 is missing, we will go for 8 if 8 is functional. And for the anteriors, 1 is missing, we will go for 2-1 in case of upper arch and 4-1 in case of lower arch. If the substituted tooth is missing, we do not record the teeth over there. So now that we know which tooth will be recorded, so using what you will record it. So the armamentarium for this is a mouth mirror and the number 23 explorer, or the shepherd's hook explorer, the picture of which could be seen in the slide given below. And how do you record them? This index has got two components, the debris component, the DIS, or the calculus component, CIS. So the scoring for the debris index is, it is 0, 1, 2 and 3. So 0 is given if there are no debris present, and 1 if it is covering 1/3, you will go for score 1. If it is between 1/3 and 2/3, you will go for score 2. And if it is more than 2/3, you will go for score 3. For score 1, apart from the debris covering 1/3 of the tooth surface, if any extrinsic stain is present without debris or regardless of the debris present, you will give them a score 1. So if a stain is present in this tooth surface, on any surface, not just on the 1/3, even let it be on 2/3, 3/3, you will give them a score 1. So this is for scoring of debris index. The next is calculus index. Remember, you will have to score the debris index first and then followed by the calculus index. So for calculus index, you again have scores from 0 to 3, where 0 is absence or no calculus present. And score 1 is present of a supragingival calculus in the 1/3 of the tooth surface.
And in score 2, the same supragingival calculus is present within the 1/3 and 2/3. Apart from that, you will also give them a score 2 if you find any flex of subgingival calculus present. And score 3 is given for supragingival calculus present more than 2/3 of the surface or any band of subgingival calculus present in the subgingival area. And remember one point over here, you will exclude the tooth surfaces which are covered by full crown restorations, that is fixed partial dentures or RCT treated tooth which is being fixed by a crown will not be taken into consideration. And also tooth which is being hit by trauma or which is being suffering from LS class 1, class 2, such tooth will also not be considered for this OHIS index. So now that we have seen that how to record this, let us also have a video demonstration.
Today we are going to see about oral hygiene index simplified demonstration. So the instruments required are the mouth mirror and then number 23 explorer or shepherd's hook. So how do you do that? You have got 6 index teeth to measure it. So these include 16, 11, 26, 46, 31 and 36. And in the lower region, in the posterior 3-6 and 4-6, you'll measure in the lingual surface. And 3-1, 1-1, 2-6 and 1-4, 1-6, you will measure in the buccal region. So how do you measure this? It has got two components, debris and calculus component. And first you will go for debris followed by calculus component. So how do you do it? You divide the teeth into 3 1/3, that is 1, 2 and 3, you will divide them. That is the incisal 1/3, middle and the cervical 1/3, as you can see in this tooth. So that is the cervical 1/3, and that is since it's near to the cervical region, and then the lowermost is the incisal 1/3. So now you're going to take the explorer, keep it parallel to the long axis of the tooth, and you will do a drifting motion. That is, you will run through the tooth surface in a drifting motion. So first you will start with the incisal 1/3, and then you will move on to the, like this, you will drift it and you will look for any debris is present in naked eye. And then you will move on to the middle 1/3. So between the cervical and the incisal, middle 1/3, you will move, and then you will again run it over the surface and drift it like this and look for any debris is present. And then you will go to the cervical 1/3, drift it over and look for any debris is present. How do you score them? If it is present in the incisal 1/3, you will give them a score as 3. If it is present between the cervical and the middle 1/3, you will give them a score as 2. And if it is present only in the cervical 1/3, you will give them a score as 1. And apart from this, 1 is also scored if any extrinsic stain is present, irrespective of the surface. That is, it can be present in the incisal, middle or the cervical. Wherever it is present, if a stain is present on the tooth, then it is given a score as 1. Now we have seen the debris. The next, we will go for the calculus component. So calculus, how do you do it? I will demonstrate it in the lower teeth. So like you can see over here, this again is divided into 3 parts, middle, incisal and the cervical 1/3. And then again the explorer is kept in the parallel axis and run through the tooth surfaces to see any hard tenacious substance is attached to the tooth surface. If it is present in the cervical 1/3, you will give them a score as 1. And as you can see, a white area over there on the tooth, right? Over the tooth surface here, that is called the subgingival region. So when I run the probe over the subgingival region, it should be run smoothly. If that is present, then it means that there is a band of subgingival calculus where it will be given a score of 3. If when I run and I am able to find some kind of a resistance, then it is called flex of calculus, then that subgingival calculus will be given a score of 2. And apart from that, for you also have supragingival calculus criteria. That is, if it is present, the supragingival criteria is present in the incisal 1/3, you will give a score 1. If it is between 1 and 2 in the incisal region, you will give a score 3. If it is in the cervical region, you will give as score 1. The same like debris. So this is how you will be recording the calculus component and the debris component of the oral hygiene index.
So now we have seen how we record it. So you, once you have made the record, you will put them in this format where you will give the scores on each box and you will calculate the final score over here. How do you calculate them? Using this formula. So for DIS, that is a debris, you will be letting the total score divided by the number of surface. For calculus is again total score by number of surface. So this number of surfaces will be 6 maximum if all the index teeth are present, and 0 if none of the teeth is being recorded. And then you will calculate the OHIS scores, which will give you and range from 0 to 3. And this will be given some interpretation. That is, if it is from 0 to 0.6, it is good. 0.7 to 1.8, it is fair. 1.9 to 3, it is poor. And next, you will calculate the OHIS score, which is nothing but the summation of this DIS with this CIS. That is, calculus and debris score together will give you the oral hygiene simplified score, which is nothing but 0 to 1.2 will be good, 1.3 to 3 will be fair, 3.1 to 6 is poor. So the whole purpose of this OHIS is to determine the oral hygiene status of a particular person. Though this index is being widely used in community regions because of its simplified methodology of recording it, this is one index which you need to keep in mind, because it is very simple to record and it can record huge number of people, and it is most commonly used in community services. Thank you.